The following podcast by Tom Mabe contains hilarious content. You should not drive or operate heavy machinery while listening.
Getting revenge is sweet. They've been calling him at home. Revenge is sweet. Selling something he don't want to own. Revenge is sweet. Now he's messing with their minds. Tom Mabe is gonna show them.
Hey guys, happy new year. Wow, it's my fourth podcast. Pretty excited about that. And can I start off by saying I hate bad customer service. And my cell phone company, they suck. I mean, oh my God. True story. I called them up. I said, look, every time I use my cell phone, I got an echo in my voice. And the girl's like, I can't hear an echo. And I said, well, I'm calling from a landline right now. It's, well, sir, if I can't hear an echo, I can't help you out. So like, daggone, I mean, I'm the customer. Jeez, I mean, in this economy, you're gonna act like that when it's tough to even get a job. So I was pretty ticked off. So the next day, I had one of my best buddies at the house. I said, look, I want to call my cell phone company. I'm going to tell them I got an echo in my voice, and I want you to play the part of the echo. So here's that actual call. Of all the hundreds of calls I've done, I think this is the most creative one I've ever pulled off. So here you go.
May I have your cell phone number, including the area code?
502-3792.
Thank you. Hold one moment, please. May I ask whom I'm speaking with?
Tom Mabe.
Thank you, Mr. Mabe. How may I help you today?
Yeah, every time I use my cell phone, I got an echo in my voice.
I'll be trying to use my phone to get an echo and stuff.
An echo, sir?
Yes, it's weird. It kind of makes me sound like a black man.
It made me sound like an African-American cracker.
Sir, do you mainly notice this when you're roaming or outside of the calling area?
Sometimes I'm like in a questionable part of town.
Sometimes when I'm over my baby mama house, I can't hear my people.
Well, you could try turning down the volume on your headset.
Oh, I can do that?
Oh, for real?
Yeah, you could try that.
Oh, let me try that while I got you on the phone. Hold on. Man, I don't think that works.
That ain't hitting on nothing.
Sir, you can update your phone by hitting *228.
I've done that.
I don't know. I did try to get a new car from the liquor store, and it ain't working.
I don't think I can help you. You probably need to take your phone to one of our local retail stores.
Yeah, I don't want to do all that.
I ain't feeling it.
Well, sir, I don't think there's anything I can do to help you.
I'm not trying to be rude here, but is there anyone else I can talk with, babe?
Who your boss is?
Guys, I don't think this is very funny.
Look, here's the deal. Your customer service is off. I'm just trying to get my phone fixed. I'm thinking about writing a letter to someone.
I'm about to jack somebody up. Meet me outside.
You can't write a letter. Goodbye.
So there you go. That's me and my echo. Like me and my shadow, but me and my echo. And that was a feature of one of my best buddies, Keith McGill. And I can't tell you how many different stores we called trying to get that right. Because a lot of people, they didn't even acknowledge that I had a black echo. And they kept on trying to help me out. But that lady, she definitely got frazzled a little bit. Yeah, so been listening to a lot of other podcasts, and here, like, it seems like a lot of people are doing like a year in review, you know, the best things, the worst things about 2011. And 2011 was pretty good for me. A lot of the things do stand out. When they captured and killed Osama bin Laden, that stood out to me. I remember being at the airport in Houston when they got Gaddafi. They had the sound down on CNN. I'm sitting there, and I swear, I look up myself. Oh my God, they killed Carlos Santana. And I was like, because it looks just. Now, you know, if they could just kill the Kardashian television show, that would be, wow, wouldn't that be the trifecta? So looking back at other stuff, yeah, I did this bit in 2011. I've done this bit every year for 10 years, and it's actually on my YouTube channel, Mabe in America. It's called Feeding the Homeless. And here's the premise. So every time I see a couple homeless guys, you know, sitting outside of a restaurant or burger joint, I'll pull up in my car and I'll find the number to the burger joint, and I'll call it up and go, yeah, this is Sergeant Tom Mabe. Can I speak to the manager, please? And they'll get the manager. Yeah, this is Sergeant Tom Mabe. I just want to give you guys a heads up. We got a couple undercover agents outside disguised as homeless people. And if you could do us a huge favor, they're going to be out there for like 8 or 9 hours doing some surveillance work. If you could possibly maybe send them out a couple cups of coffee, some cheeseburgers, we'd really appreciate it. And they go, well, yeah, can't you guys do that? No, we don't want to blow their cover. You know, whatever you do, you know, when you just bring it out to them, lay it next to them, walk away. And I promise every time, 5 minutes later, some kid comes out and he has a couple cups of coffee stacked on top of each other and a bag of burgers. He lays them next to him. And he walks away like this walk that reads like, I'm part of a sting operation. So I did that in 2011. I'll keep on doing that. Oh, geez. What a great bit. Now, again, that's on my YouTube channel, Mabe in America. And we're getting back to the cell phone. I love that call. And my cell phone truly, I'll butt dial people. When my phone's not even in my pocket, I'll just my phone's sitting next to me, and I'll go, what the hell was that? And I hear someone screaming, Tommy, pick up the phone. So I thought, you know, maybe I could have some fun with the butt dials. And I did a couple of these right before I put the last CD out. Just threw them on there for kicks. But this is a different twist on the butt dials. Check this out.
It's time for another episode of Butt Dial Diaries. Listen as Tom Mabe butt dials people on purpose, not by accident.
Hey, what's up?
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Tommy.
Oh, don't stop. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Tommy!
Oh, God, that feels good. Oh, yeah, right there. Right. Oh, yeah, don't stop.
Having
sex. That is so great. Oh, God, listen, man. Oh, yeah. Oh,
easy.
Not so hard. Oh, yeah. Oh, the lotion. That's good. I like the lotion.
Tommy!
Oh, God. Oh, you're so good at that. Oh, God. I'm sorry. That's embarrassing. It's just, it's so much. Oh, God.
Tune in next time for Butt Dial Diaries.
That's just silly. That's fun. Hey, let's go to a couple questions here. Let me pull these up on the email. Okay, this question is from Walt from Alabama. Love your podcast on iTunes. I was wondering, have you ever started a prank bit and then realized you really should talk to the people who you were calling? Maybe a real oh crap moment. So have I ever started a prank and realized, oh crap, this is I'm going to go to jail or something like that? Yes, a couple of times. I called immigration and the report, I had like, what, 7 or 8 illegal aliens trapped on my neighbor's roof. They were up there stealing his shingles. And I didn't bust a bit, but I called the guy right back and let him in what was going on. And you know, we're actually going to feature that call on the next podcast. So, Walt, thanks. I'll be listening to the next podcast. We'll definitely play Illegal Aliens on the Roof. Let's see. The next question is, well, all the way from Finland. Let's see. It's kind of broken. Longtime fan of yours from Finland. I would like to ask from you. Okay. Have you ever gotten into trouble with police or other officials like Child Protection because of your pranks? Cops have showed up the house many a times. Never had Child Protection. We'll also feature a call called Low Self-Esteem. It's a call about my kid. Maybe we'll do that in the next podcast too. But thanks. Yeah, all the way from Finland. Pretty cool. They didn't leave a name. Otherwise, I would say so. And this question is from Daniel. Do you plan on coming down under to Australia? Would be awesome to see your live act. God, you know, I've never been to Australia. I was with Capitol Records and Capitol Nashville. Mike Dungan gave me a deal after I left Virgin Records. And there's an artist, you know, Keith Urban. He's on Capitol Nashville. And I've always wanted to go. It sounds like a beautiful place. And wow. But no plans. I will be in Kearney, Nebraska doing a corporate show next week. So anyway, hey guys, before I forget, check out adamandeve.com. And right now, for a limited time, you'll get 50% off just about any item. And when you select your one item at 50% off, you'll also receive, check it out, 3 free adult DVDs plus a free extra gift. And to top it off, they will give you free shipping on everything. So there you go. When you do get the free DVDs, just use the offer code SIDESHOW upon checkout. So adamandeve.com. So there you have it, guys. I want to wish everyone a happy new year, and thanks so much for all the kind words and listening to my podcast. I think next I'm going to feature a couple longer calls on the next podcast. And be sure to subscribe to it and check me out on YouTube. I've got about 100 videos on YouTube right now. It's called Mabe in America. That's one word, Mabe in America. And follow me on Twitter at Tom Mabe. And thanks for all your questions and Happy New Year.
Getting revenge is sweet. They've been calling him at home. Revenge is sweet. Selling something he don't want to own. Revenge is sweet. Now he's messing with their minds. Tom Mabe's gonna show them that one cold at a time. Yeah, man, go get him, Tom.
What do you think I'm doing over here?
I've got one for you, sir.
Oh, what's that?
How many telemarketers does it take to kick your ass?
Hello?